But we always find that one small little thing that always makes us laugh. Let's begin with Trump, whose visit meeting Donald Trump. First of all, is it just me and the internet at large? But Trump was looking literally orange. That's one. Nothing new, one. Two, but a lot of Kenyans were saying, with President Uhuru Kenyatta now there, his twang colors add. Stevens, let me begin with you.
Can I have a twang?
Yeah, you can say with a twang.
From McQueenie, right? Yeah.
Feel free.
I, like you say, Kenyans will always find also something to say about everything. We like to make humor, even when you have all those things going around our lives, corruption and all that. Great visit. We can't underrate the fact and the reasons why the president went over and, you know, bring goodies to us and all that. But again, talking about Trump and yellow and red, and also the rants he was making about social media the whole week, about Google and all
and
those
Twitter
things.
And Twitter and Facebook, yeah.
Like, you always target me to make money. I found that hilarious, but at some point I thought, yes, probably this is true, that those platforms would use prominent people just to push numbers and also to make money. I think there was a fact in it.
Stevens, and here's the thing. A lot of the bilateral talks we see, and especially even with Trump and May and, Trump and Uhuru, May and Uhuru. Let me say this specifically for Trump, because it is America, America, Hollywood, the home of entertainment. I'd want to believe, I'd feel like, especially in this day where you have a lot of young people in the entertainment industry, that perhaps an advisor of President Uhuru Kenyatta would say, as part from just getting a wind energy project or a tech or something that has that will, yes, be of economic value, can we see how we can tap into U.S. Entertainment to help grow Kenya's entertainment back at home, therefore creating still an employment, if we're looking at it from an economic point of view, therefore strengthening and entertainment here in Kenya. Why don't we not see that? As much as we talk about wind energy and education and good health, which is all fantastic, but no one has told them about the entertainment industry and how they can leverage as well.
I think it starts from where they're starting from, honestly, that we can at least have a relationship as in America, bring the old good days back, probably. People are, I don't know if we're facing East or West, but we're facing what we're facing, and that's a good thing for the country. And yes, I think with the showbiz industry opening and for us, like Angela would say, talk about policies and stuff like that, all those things would open up. And of course, it starts from where we sit. It starts with policymakers. It starts with the government. It starts with the ministry, youth, and all those things. If they're put together, and yes, with all those four pillars coming up, I think it's a good chance for us. The mood is right for us as creatives to get there.
Okay. So Donald Trump and the whole visit between Donald Trump and Uhuru Kenyatta is not the only thing that got the attention of Kenyans, but not just Kenyans, the entire African continent. Remember the dance move that Theresa May was trying to pull off in South Africa? It became even the talk of the town. You know, instead of even the fact that he was meeting Cyril Ramaphosa, I want you to take a look at this dance. These guys are laughing, but you know what I think? First of all, Kenya hasn't had an entire prime minister from Britain visit us in about 30 years, but the last one was 1988 by Margaret Thatcher. I like the fact that Theresa May can move from sitting at a high table meeting to dancing. Liz, you're here laughing. Your thoughts on it?
I don't think she should. We appreciate the fact you came and visit. We appreciate that whole fact. And I've realized, actually, she's not the only one who has this problem. People in power cannot move to save their life. I don't know, once you get into that seat, Angela, maybe you can prove us wrong, because I realize people in power cannot move to save their lives.
Right.
No,
whether,
it's so steep.
Whether an African politician or a politician from America or abroad.
Obama did a good dance with Saudi Soul when he
no,
was there.
Obama was kind of stiff as well.
Okay, Angela, my thoughts are like, this. She can move from a high-level power meeting and then decide to let her hair down. Yeah. How many people can do that? Try dancing with Vladimir Putin. He would stand still. And I'm like, when you're done, let me know.
Yeah, I love it. Even the way she's really, you know, picking something from the ground.
Wonderful. I think for, you know, Alida with her stature, you know, I think that was just 100%.
Even though there was zero coordination.
Yes, yeah. That's
well, what do you mean zero coordination?
There was coordinated.
That is what you make it.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be like those boys like... She's maybe, just doing that.
Or maybe that's the new dance move. You know?
Oh, we can just, that has come across the board.
We can,
okay. Are you guys not seeing you defend
some character?
But you know what? Somebody of you know that stature and that age. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a kudos. I'll give now that an 8 out of 10.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, now you'd give that one an 8 out of 10.
Yeah.
Okay. Release is there laughing. All right. But what are your thoughts? We'd love to hear your thoughts in regards to that matter. Nevertheless, if there's something else that has also caught the attention of people online, it is Serena Williams. Mm. Now, Serena Williams was banned from wearing her catsuit playing. And for those who know that catsuit was just not another fashion statement, that catsuit was specifically made for medical purposes for her. She's been facing a lot of medical problems before and after having her child. And that catsuit is supposed to help prevent blood clots, especially for, you know, a tennis player such as her kind. But then the body just went ahead and decided, you know what, we're going to ban the catsuit. And a lot of people thought that was not fair. Nevertheless, she has been playing the last two matches, especially the one that was done yesterday. She has been playing in her tutus, and she's been nailing them. Let me begin with Mwendo here. You're the man in this regards. So we have decided to ban her catsuit, and because we want her in a miniskirt, because I feel like that's the best way to play tennis. And she said, fine, miniskirt it is, I'm going to wear a tutu and I'm going to win at it.
She said, fine, and she's like, okay, it is still also a fashion statement and don't expect me to wear this again next year. And the choices are many. But again, coming down to the reasons again why she was wearing that, and with so much respect to mothers and, you know, it's after giving birth and all that, and the reason why she was doing it, I think I support the fact that she stood on her ground and women were behind her and everybody was behind her. Like, you should understand.
She's
not just making a fashion statement. She's pulling people to, you know, to the court, and she's saying, yes, I've given birth. I'm this shape and this is why I'm wearing this. And I think it was a mistake for them to just go ahead and without giving basic reasons and giving reason to it,
right,
we'll just go ahead and say we ban this.
All right, fantastic. Liz, your thoughts?
I fail to understand what they really are criticizing, because we are there to see her play, not to see whatever she's wearing. So I fail to understand why they feel the need to just put a restriction on what one should wear. So wearing a tutu wearing a miniskirt is the right form of attire to play tennis.
Yes.
Like, let's be real over here. And there's a tennis player, a white tennis player. I forget her name, unfortunately. But in 1987, she also wore a catsuit. So why was it okay for her and not okay for Serena?
That's the thing. A lot of people are not even looking at this as a gender issue, but more of a racial issue,
It is.
And again, it still stems back to the fact that this is not a fashion statement. Does she look good in a catsuit? Fantastic, yes.
Yeah.
But for her, it was more of a medical reason. That catsuit was created to help with the blood clot and etc. But Angela, your thoughts on this one?
Yeah, well, as you said, you know, I think it's very crucial to, you know, as you go through motherhood, for those who also go through motherhood, you appreciate the fact that there are conditions that you'd be able to face afterwards. I think it was unfair. We appreciate, of course, the rules that are there, regulations for a particular sport, but sometimes there should be exceptions. There are always exceptions to the rule.
You know what I love? Nike, because she's one of the ambassadors for Nike, went ahead and tweeted, of course, a photo of her, saying, and I quote, "You can't take the superhero out of her costume, but you can never take away her superpower."
That's true.
I was like, 2-0, right? Yeah. And here's the thing. for Serena Williams, Angela, and I'm glad because you brought in the aspect of being a mother. For Serena Williams, this was her first child, so she had and giving birth as a black woman because of, I think, I remember right reading the article, because of our DNA strand in your late years again on top of that. Everything seems to be against you. So she had difficulty with her first pregnancy. And this was the first time we've been seeing her play in this French Open since having her child. So she has the pressure, first of all, of whether she will perform to her best of ability, especially now that her body is not literally the same as it was after her child. Then now she has to deal with this negativity from the French Open, saying, and for her it was just a medical reason. And even from a legal perspective, how would you have handled that?
Well, you know, as I said, you know, there are usually rules and regulations, but there are always exceptions, you know, and medical reasons sometimes should be part of those exceptions. So I think it's about looking at it, you know, in a broader perspective and seeing how best, you know, to approach it. If it's a medical reason that is she's not able, I mean, that would protect her, her health, you know, then I don't think that they should have banned it. But I'm sure there's more to it, you know, that.
You know what also perplexes me is that even Stevens, for a woman such as Serena Williams, who is a successful woman, she still has to go through the racial biasness and the gender issue. No matter how successful a black woman is, there'll always be other things, these same things that are coming down and still attacking her. Your thoughts on that? And not just her, but just women in general.
One, the Williams have always made headlines, whatever they were. I mean, like Nike would say, you cannot get her from who she is. That's the first thing. But again, gender issues, we've had problems with this of time immemorial. Black Americans, blacks, we're fighting for their rights. I don't think really it's an issue that would say somebody else will come and help us. I think the noise that's been going on, we've seen this with BETs and all that. And the space is opening for everyone to speak for themselves and just create that chance and that opportunity for us to be equals in the world. And I think it's a question of time. It's a matter of time that, well, this is done and gone. And we're not there to, again, cry every time about, oh, we're blacks and we've been attacked. I think it's about time we just say whatever it is and let's move on with life. And I think the space will open.
And speaking of moving on with life, what do you have for us in the past this morning?
I have everything good as usual.
take us through it. Why should people grab a copy of the Pulse today?
We have everything good and we all know we heard what happened around the club around Thika Road sometimes 2 weeks ago. A girl who claimed to have been raped in or around the club. And the story was big this week. Guys were out there to protest. A number of people were arrested. Two people were arrested. The matter never went too far. But that's one of the stories that we have on page 6, if we just stand there. Did rape happen or did an attack happen in the club or on a woman or was it just another hate battles between clubs?
All right,
you know, so because that happens a lot.
The Pulse looks into that.
Right.
Okay.
If you move on, we just have that story on, like you were saying, the Kobe challenge.
The Kobe, yes, something that, it dropped social media.
And you just touched that when you're just talking to Angela about social media and the pressure that many celebrities will go through in terms of creating numbers, in terms of being relevant. And we're just looking at some of those, and I can see you on that page. Some of those stunts that celebrities will pull just to keep relevant.
Right.
And, you know, I don't know if you'd pull some.
Who? Me?
This is the celebrity.
No. I've got pressure. I never allow it to get to me. Tell Angela. I'm going to be learning from her. She's the one who seems to have mastered it.
Yeah. And you know, our cover story, where you are again, it's about in karaoke and, you know, just be happy. It's what we have on the headline of the rhythms of the night. Guys will make people happy at the night.
Can you make karaoke, Stevens?
My friends sing. My friends
not
sing.
Not your friends. I'm saying you. You do sing.
Yeah, they're the ones, but they don't have those ones there. My songs are never there.
Your songs are never there. The songs that work with your vocals.
No. I think, and again, it's about the karaoke thing. I think we've westernized the whole karaoke thing, and it's about the American song. And why can't they give me a Kenya Maria kind of lyrics, and I'll sing so perfectly. You'll be so shocked that I would go out there when I'm just watching those things. And I'm like, no, give me a mic and let me sing my thing.
They're just not playing the right kind of music for you. Is that it? Oh my goodness.
No, It's good to express yourself from the local context, and that's what we support every time as Pulse.
Okay.
Not every time, you know, let's do Western, let's do Mike Jackson and all those moves. That's not us. But beyond that, a lot of gossip we have today. If you turn to page 19, amazing stuff.
Okay, what is so interesting is also the Nairobi, and we know what has been happening this week with the high legal drama that we've been seeing in the DCJ's office. The Nairobian went a step further, and they have this headline, which can be found on page 9 if you grab your copy of a Nairobian. Why I divorced Milu, ex-husband, case closed. She sheds tears at the sight of poor market women, but has a side Kenyans won't know. And it's not just that. Okay, people are just leaving each other. Wife leaves Ababu Namamba. What is happening?
It's time to leave.
It's time to leave. Like Stevens.
It is true. It's time to leave.
People are just exiting. No. Come on. Liz.
For Ababu, I think his situation is kind of different. He is a man who, can I say, new money and then has to enjoy the new money, and that comes with a lot of women and temptation. Mm. So unfortunately, he's unable to keep it one.
I mean, that speaks more volume about one's character.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
When the money comes, why should that change you?
It does change some people. Not everyone is strong enough to handle it and become humble. Some are just, it gets into their head.
All right, so we need to close it up. Angela, what are you going to be doing this weekend? What do lawyers do?
Oh, goodness. I'm going to be a mother this weekend. Next week is school, so we have a lot of school runs to do.
Okay.
Yes.
For you?
I like that she says next week is school. The other schools open.
Oh, goodness.
So these ones are open.
The ones that children go to are not open, Stevens. What is the problem? What about you? What are you going to be up to?
A lot of stuff. Like we say, page 3 just tells you where the gigs are happening across the country. But a very special one for us that we would be partnering with Marsh Auto to do the auto and beauty and fashion thing at KWS.
Okay, Liz?
On Sunday.
I'm going to take it easy this weekend. I'm just going to be one of those guys who just watch TV, Suits, something. I don't know. So a season has to be watched this weekend.
This weather? I hear you. All right, thank you guys so much for coming. Angela, I hope you come back again. I'm going to let this go because you said you have a cold. But next time, you're going to have to sing.
Sure.
All right, thank you so much. And this is where we're going to close off Morning Express. Thank you so much for your time and your company for the past 3 hours. I'll see you again tomorrow morning. Express bright and early at 8 a.m. My name is Zinzi Kibiku. Good morning.